On some very rare occasions, we've covered some interesting and important research papers on this channel, and I feel like this is one of those times again. Programming socks. Is it high time for thigh highs? An investigation into the perceived unreasonable effectiveness of programming socks on productivity levels in the field of software engineering. Yes, this is a piece that was actually published. Now, where it was published, well, we'll get to that one in just a bit, but just know for now that it technically has been published. Programming socks are thigh-high length or thigh-high socks, commonly striped, but not as a critical necessity. See figure 1 for an example, that being this one here. As an example of the stripe variety, here you go. They've been long hailed as essential items to improve programmer performance, code quality, as well as job satisfaction. This is an undeniable fact. Everybody already knows this. All the best programmers wear them. Other related items that are known to be useful for programming include cat tails, cat ears, mittens, and miniskirts. Surprisingly, garments traditionally designed for the duties of a French housemaid are purportedly equally effective, if not more so, in the realm of software development. I provide this as an example. According to informal polls with select groups, public opinion suggests that the attire helps to promote clean code practices as well. Now, this might be the one part that's actually a downgrade. Some people take clean code a little bit too far, so if you try to level up a bit too much, you might end up actually harming your code. Other innovations of note, including replacing the long-beloved practice of talking to rubber ducks to assist in debugging issues, a cuddlier substitute has been found in the popular Swedish furniture store, IKEA. The plush shark Blaha appears to be more appealing to both new and old developers alike. The new practice of verbal debugging with the shark toys has been coined as blah blah blaha, but the term has yet to catch on because the author just made it up. Here we have a bunch of feet pics. These are from the social news aggregation site reddit.com. While some communities on Reddit are dedicated to the promotion of the practice, e.g. r/unixsocks, there are several examples of programmer socks under discussion in other areas of the website, e.g. r/Brisbane of Australia, because no matter what we're talking about, Australia has to be involved. In that r/Brisbane post, someone was trying to acquire some programming socks, and all of the replies were people just being very confused about what programming socks are. They thought, oh, it was socks that were themed about programming. They didn't have any idea what was going on. And key attributes were gleaned from this data using widely available organic ocular systems, also known as your eyeballs. What is very unclear from this research is whether or not programming socks have any effect on data collection ability as well. It is very possible it is a cross-discipline enhancer, and that may have possibly skewed the results. The principal metric we wished to observe was whether programmers who wore programming socks were truly as productive as expected. Figure 3 shows a breakdown of technical content on wearer screens. There was a surprising lack of interactive development environments, text editors, or other signs of code production. However, the overwhelming majority of wearers had terminals visible, often with prominent ASCII art logos in transgender and non-binary color schemes. We know they are non-binary because it was drawn in ASCII. By definition, it is not binary. Of the dataset, 75.7% had a terminal open. This was very likely running an app like HiFetch, NeoFetch, or FastFetch. 12% had code visible, and 12.2% didn't know how to open a terminal and didn't understand the assignment. From this data, we can only conclude that either programming socks have become more mainstream and non-programmers wearing these socks are developing into programmers themselves, which I think is a pretty good conclusion, or that programming socks are so effective that the majority of wearers in our datasets simply finished their software and did not need to do any additional coding because it increased their productivity so high they can just sit around and just take pictures of their feet. Either way, this result is a clear endorsement of their usage. Further research is desirable to investigate these effects when paired with the additional attire mentioned in section 1. But the most important question is what kind of programming socks, because there isn't just one kind available. There are, however, general trends in the space. Striped socks are significantly more popular than non-striped socks, as shown here, 76.4% striped, 23.6% non-striped. And there is a clear preference for some basic colors. Whilst I do have these amazing socks here, if you were to ask me which ones I prefer, I would probably go for the non-striped variety myself. Now, I do think this data is good, but there is one thing I would have liked to see. What the preference looks like if you also compare this with the striped and non-striped variety as well. Like, what colors are generally opted for in both of those different categories? I would imagine that in the non-striped variety, it's probably going to be mainly black and white and not as much the color, but I'm not really sure based on the data we have here. That's just my educated guess based on the listings available on Amazon, but Australian Amazon maybe has different results than what's available on the US or other versions out there. And speaking of the Amazon listings, Amazon search settings. When searching for programming socks on Amazon.com, the majority of listings are correctly indexed as thigh-high socks. There are a limited amount of novelty socks with a programming theme, for example, this and this, and an equal amount of novelty socks that were unrelated to programming, for example, these pizza socks. There were also a few shoes and gloves, because Amazon is Amazon, and sometimes things get indexed really weirdly. We decided to not divide programming socks into subcategories, such as ones that had paw pads on their toes, fluff and glitter, or small teddy bear faces at their peak. So of the data, 47.1% were actually on topic, 21.9% were novelty but still on topic regarding programming, 25.2% were novelty and completely off topic, and 5.7% Amazon was just making things up. Now, all of this is great, but I'm really interested about the interest in programming socks. Google Trends gave us some interesting insight into the worldwide appeal of programmer socks. They are particularly of interest to Western countries, United States, Australia, need I show you the picture again, United Kingdom, but also Eastern Europe, Poland, and Russia. Now, I don't understand why these two particular countries of all other countries could be on the list. If someone has any insight on that, please let me know. I would love to know. And even though Australia has absolutely no one living here, we control everything. Australia is going to inject itself into everything possible. Anything you like, anything you hate, there is almost certainly an Australian involved. But I feel like for those Eastern European countries, that deserves a whole nother research paper specifically focusing on that topic. And here we have something very interesting. Programming socks have become increasingly of interest since the early 21st century, 2018, and continue to grow. Figure 8, as the world consistently increases the number of software developers in its population, and the benefits of programming socks have become better known, this number will surely continue to skyrocket. However, the highest point isn't in the modern era where people know about programming socks. In fact, the highest interest is closer to 2004-2005. With this, we can only conclude that programming socks may have a deeper history than previously known. Possibly a well-guarded secret by the programming elite, or maybe a handful of developers in the know who made irregular spike purchases of huge orders in order to save on shipping costs. I have the feeling that the most logical thing to assume here is all of the great software projects were built on the back of programmer socks. Torvalds with Linux, Bill Gates, Dennis Ritchie, Donald Knuth, programmer socks. This piece was published in the 2024 edition of Sig Bovic by the Association for Computational Heresy on April 0th. Now, if you couldn't tell already, it should have been pretty obvious by the title of the piece. This is a satirical paper in a satirical organization published in a satirical proceedings. But it has been going on for the past 17 years. Every single year, there is all manner of topics. The main focus is things relating to tech and computers, but they do accept papers for various other topics as well. If you are bored and you want something fun to read about, just go open up one random year and just start scrolling. Just see what papers got published that year, because some of them, besides the topic that it's on, are actually really, really well written, and if you don't pay enough attention, you could assume it was a real paper. Yes, I am 4 months late to this being published to actually talk about it, but it doesn't change the fact that a lot of people still don't know about it, so regardless, here we are. So if you learned something new, I don't know how you did, but let me know. That's awesome. That's good for you. And if you liked the video, go like the video. So if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, and Verify linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And my legs are a little bit too big to wear these, so I'm going to take them off now.